Good evening. Welcome to the Don't Unfriend Me Show at The Dumb Show or thedumbshow.com. You can find us across all social media. And if you're confused about where to find us, you can just go to thedumbshow.com and get all of our shows. Welcome to the Don't Unfriend Me Show / Breaking Truth. Tonight, we're talking about Katy Perry. It's going to be some fireworks. We might see the peacock. No, that's on ABC. That doesn't work. Trying to think of any of her songs. This will be a teenage dream for all of us. I can't do it anymore. I tried. So folks, what are we talking about? We're talking about Katy Perry, but I want to make sure we keep it at Katy Perry. This topic is very delicate because there was an episode of American Idol that gets a little emotional because it's an emotional topic. It's about school shootings. This young man was a contestant. I'm going to talk to you about what I took umbrage with. I want to make sure we understand that it has nothing to do with the survivor of Santa Fe, Texas. I was in Houston at the time. I understand it. I lived in Colorado through Columbine. I lived through the Aurora movie shooting in Colorado. I get it. I am a gun enthusiast. This is a delicate topic. I want to keep our sights on Katy Perry, American Idol, Biggest Loser, America's Got Talent, all that stuff, because I believe they're taking advantage of people, yet they have a platform of wokeness that's just driving me crazy. We'll talk about it in a few seconds, right on the rebound of this message. By the way, Matthew Spear, that's me, that's you. Let's get to it, and we will listen to the Hodge Twins and then be right back.
Hey, Hodge Twins here. Check out our friend Matthew Spear at his podcast, at The Dumb Show, and his website,
yeah.
Don'tunfriendme.com.
Yeah.
And welcome to the Don't Unfriend Me Show. I appreciate it. Plus, you might hear some commercials on the podcast, or you might see them on Facebook. Please do me a favor. I know it's frustrating. We try to keep it down to two or three a show, but it's really out of our control. But it does keep the lights on and pay the bills. So does going over to the Don't Unfriend Me store and buying some shirts and hats and stuff at thedumbshow.com. All right. Got to get my plugs in. Katy Perry. I'm not going to lie to you. I have teenage dream plays and I tap my foot. Fireworks. I despise the song. I think it's horrible. Katy Perry doesn't have a ton of talent when it comes to vocal range. She's not an amazing singer. Her performances are a little off and weird. I'm not a huge fan, but it doesn't mean I can't appreciate that she's got some catchy music like most performers. Otherwise, they wouldn't be where they're at. There's some who are just absolutely ridiculously horrible at what they do, and I don't know how they get there. But Katy Perry does have some talent, or at least used to. Now, I don't know what the heck she's doing. The reason I take an issue, and I want to be clear here. Like I said, this has nothing to do with the young man who was on, but everything to do with the way that they are treating this gentleman as some sort of commodity for ratings. We'll talk about it in a brief second, but first let's start the video so you can see this, and I will commentate in between and all around. Here we go.
This is not okay. You should be singing here because you love music.
You're 21, so you're not in school?
No. Yeah, no, I'm a full-time mattress salesman.
Awesome.
Well, slinging spring, baby.
Wow.
What you gonna sing there?
All right, so first off, once again, here we go. We're gonna just get your sensitive feelers and put them away. Carterize those bad boys. They already know the story, right? Every single judge knows who's coming up. The producers have prepped them. They kind of know what they're going to see, so they know how to react. They all get on the same page, or they get their controversy. This is a show. It is designed to essentially be stage theater. This is not impromptu. It's all set up. Why? Because there's millions upon millions of dollars at stake. Now, when you've got somebody like, you know, this gentleman, who obviously is an amazing talent, who can sing incredibly well, the chances of him making it big are slim to none. No offense to his weight. I wasn't making a pun. But there have been people who have gone through and done very, very well through American Idol. Now, understand that they have to sign their lives away to a contract. They have to pay 50% of the marketing back. I mean, there's an incredible owed amount of dollars to these talent shows for being found. Same thing with Shark Tank and all these others. This is what they do. And it's a commodity based upon you and your talent or product or ability to lose weight or make a Sichuan salad, if that's what it's called, effectively with a paring knife and a couple of heads of lettuce. I don't know. But whatever it is, it's not just that anymore. This isn't Star Search where, you know, Britney Spears would walk up and she would sing and everyone would applaud and then she would get whatever the reward was. Now you have to sell your soul in a contract, in a blood contract, in order to make it big. But let alone that, to some people, is worth it. But in my eyes, having them milk off of my tragedy is not something that I'd be willing to do. Now, here's why I say that specifically, because nobody comes up there with a happy story. It's few and far between. It's like a lunar eclipse at high tide with the carp running. It doesn't happen that often. Most of the time, it's my mother had cancer. My dad set my bed on fire. I went over a cliff in a motorhome. I had a boating accident. You know, everyone drowned. I was stuck on an island for 12 months. Tom Hanks and I were there with Spalding. I fell off the raft. Tom made it. I was stuck at sea for another 6 months. And I met the little mermaid Ariel, and she taught me how to sing. And I'm going to use my vocal cords that Ariel taught me to inspire all of you tonight. And you're just sitting there going, why do these stories have to be so grandiose? Why do they have to be so depressing? Can't we just do what the show says we're going to do? Can't we see people lose weight? Can't we see people make a great seven-star course meal with all the trimmings and capers and salad and steak and baked potato and creme brulee? Fine. But what I don't need to do, and what you don't need to do, is sell your soul in order for me to appreciate you, because really all it's about is money and ratings. So when Katy Perry goes into her tirade, I want you to listen specifically to the things she says that aren't accurate. Now, that is a lot to take in. And you might be saying, well, Matt, that's all your personal opinion, because I love these shows. That's fine. But that's what this show is. It's about opinion. And my opinion is this poor kid gets up there and he may not have wanted to talk about it. Do we know? I mean, if we truly care about people and equality and their emotions and feelings, do you think he could be suffering maybe PTS from this? Has he gotten the psychological help that he needs? Is this something he felt he had to share? Because his reaction was subdued and Katy Perry loses the plot.
I'm going to sing Stone by Whiskey Myers.
Oh.
So first off, this is one of my favorite songs of all time, and I love Whiskey Myers. If you haven't listened to their stuff, do it. It's fantastic. Listen to Frogman. It's a great song. They're amazing. You probably have already heard of them because they were in Yellowstone. They were in one of the country bars singing, actually, Frogman, and they are fantastic. Listen to Whiskey Myers. Here we go.
Well, the night is my companion to Stone.
For copyright, I can only play the song for a few seconds because I don't have the money to give these guys.
Yeah.
Katy Perry's boobs almost fall out, but that's not the highlight of the show. What the hell is she wearing? Do you guys remember those little Hawaiian dolls that would do the hula or whatever it is, and it would shake the grass skirts? That's what she reminds me of.
You think so? Y'all better sit down.
Man, you're singing from just the perfect spot,
boy. Oh, happy.
So you throw that head back, you close them eyes. Why are you doing Idol?
Great. Throw that head back, close their eyes. My wife could go on. I get it. That's horrible. Sorry, honey. Listen, that's what we're talking about, right? Just tell us how you think of the guy singing. We don't need to know. We already know he's great. We already know he's going to go to the next round. But now it's time for the sad story. Like the mullet's not bad enough. No offense, kid. Now we've got to go ahead and go into and downplay everything he just gave us, which is a plethora of emotion, outside of this story. People felt something. It was cathartic. Your soul sang along with him, or it didn't. But either way, whatever just took place was more important than anything that was about ready to take place right here.
May 2018, a gunman walked into my school. I was in art room one. He shot up art room two before he made his way to art room one. Lost a lot of friends. Eight students were killed. Two teachers were killed. And it's just really been negative, man. Santa Fe's had a bad rap here since 2018.
Okay, obviously serious. Obviously their reactions. This is not the first time hearing this. It was on national news. Their producers and scriptwriters gave them notice way ahead of time about what was going to happen on this segment. The kid did an amazing job. He sang, he crushed it. He shared his story, which is also fine and dandy. And he did it with professionalism. He didn't shed a tear. He belted it out, got it done, just like the song. And now Katy Perry has to give her opinion. And here it is. Baby, there's the waterworks. Do it until it hurts. So fake. It's fake. It's fake.
What you doing, Katy?
Well, she's faking crying, but she's actually going to produce some tears, which I'm really impressed that she got the tears coming out here. It's pretty strong.
Our country has failed us.
Okay, that's where you lose me. Our country has failed us. No, our country has not failed us. This is the greatest country in the world. You're on a show where you're getting paid $12 million a year to judge people with more talent than you have. America hasn't failed us. You failed us because you can't recognize what a monumental success you are because of our country and because of the ability to chase the American dream. But immediately, because a school shooting happened and it took place, which is horrible, America failed us. Not the shooter, not the person who actually did and perpetrated the killings.
Facts.
This is not okay. You should be singing here because you love music.
And not to go ahead and get a record contract or make American Idol millions of dollars or add an additional 1 to 2 million viewers with our extra sob stories. This isn't about the love of music. There's nothing about this show. You mock people who suck and you pretend to idolize people who do well. And if they don't produce the results you want, you kick them to the curb and they go off in obscurity and they still owe the money for the marketing, even if they didn't make enough. Go look up some of these stories. It's absolutely tragic what they do to these people. They're vampires. They're bloodsuckers. She kind of looks like one.
It's true.
Not because you had to go through that.
Yeah, I don't know what she said. When every word's a curse word, it's kind of hard to get the point.
I agree.
You didn't have to lose 8 friends. I hope that you remind people that we have to change. Because you know what? I'm scared too.
She's scared with her bodyguards who are all armed to the teeth and literally off stage about 10 feet away from her. He does have to tell this. See, that's the funny thing. You shouldn't have to lose 8 friends to come on American Idol. Do you really think that this guy would be on American Idol if he didn't lose 8 friends? Can we just be honest? I am so sick of this woke crap. Folks, I don't know, man. I feel so much better, you know, going, I got to care about people's feelings. Let me go ahead and cross that line out. I'm done doing that crap. This is not real. The sad thing is that this is something that people should hear, but they can be mutually exclusive. It doesn't have to be a zero-sum game. You've got a little bit of talent. You've got a sad story. Therefore, you get booked on American Idol. Doesn't make any sense.
It's terrible, Katy. Horrible.
Oh yeah, just let's give her a pat on the back. Listen, she's gonna pop a Valium in 2 minutes, allegedly. Katy Perry loses it on this show all the time. I'm surprised there's not a show about a ferret. And then they, you know, this is Muskrat. Muskrat lost his son and daughter, Weeble and Feeble, in a reenactment of Beastmaster. They drowned in the quicksand. Pogo and Togo, their parents. Come on! That's your poo-poo face. Just like, I ate some sour vegan bean curd and tree bark.
We have tolerated this for so long, for too long. It's become a norm.
But we've got to change.
True. I agree.
And I hope you can just...
Change means ban guns. Okay? Just FYI. Lead. How do you know? Here's the other thing. Okay. Listen, I don't understand the finer points of mascara and eyeliner, but what I do know is Katy Perry wore the waterproof mascara and eyeliner so it doesn't run. I mean, come on. Does any woman here sit here going to tell me that they wouldn't look like a raccoon or they went 12 rounds with Marvin Hagler after crying that much? Please.
For myself, for my school, for you.
Thank you.
Got you. It. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
You have a yes from me.
Kid's so polite.
Thank you, Lionel.
And I can't wait to see you at Hollywood.
Yes, sir.
Good for him. Congratulations, kiddo.
I can't talk. Yes.
Thank you, Luke.
Thank you,
Luke.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank y'all so much.
Yeah, that was awesome. A cliffhanger.
Can I come up?
Yes! Yay!
Let me buy my sweaty palms.
I bet he's dancing on the ceiling.
Katy freaking Perry. This is crazy. Lionel Richie.
Come on, man. Don't even play around.
All right. And some people are going to show you a portion of the video. I show them all here because I don't do sound bites. I don't want to do that. I don't want to give you just a little bit. It's a moving story. I get it. But Katy Perry is my target here. This woman has reinvented herself more often than Ronco. Remember the food dehydrator, set it and forget it? 2008. This is when she did I Kissed a Girl and I Liked It. And she made a ton of money on pretending she was a lesbian when she wasn't. That's kind of a big deal. 2012 and 13. She made fun of the Asians with her Japanese cultural appropriation, and she was canceled by the woke left. Can you believe that in 2012, the woke mob started? It's insane. 2014, she went after black people. This era saw Katy experiment with making fun of black people, from backup dancers fitted out with exaggerated lips and butts on the prismatic tour, whatever the hell that is. Also doing photo ops and on stage with munching on watermelon and making racial stereotypes. But in 2015 and 16, the political awakening era began with her. Then came the hate with the Donald Trump fan base and him himself. She has more reason to despise the woke culture, but alas, if she can't beat them, join them. And that's really the message here. She is now the epitome of what woke is and what it looks like. Unfortunately, some people may see the sad stories of others as an opportunity to further their own interests and gain attention or manipulate others for their own benefit. This kind of behavior can be seen as a form of emotional exploitation, as it involves taking advantage of someone's vulnerable emotional state for personal gain. There can be several reasons why people engage in this kind of behavior, but obviously in this case, it's about money. Some individuals may lack empathy or have a narcissistic personality. Katy Perry very easily could have written a check to the school and the victims and the family, or done a fundraising concert where 12 people would have showed up. But she makes it difficult for them or anyone to understand or care about the feelings of others when you make it about you. Others may be driven by a desire for attention or validation and may use someone else's story to gain sympathy or admiration from others. Katy Perry is yet again trying to rebuild her image and become even more woke by hating America on a show called American Idol. Maybe Katy Perry can go on America's Got Talent and get the golden button with her acting chops. My daughter would love it. She watches the show as I sit by and I say, oh, honey, I went through those things. Just wait until you see the message that's constantly pushed forward and the consistency in the inconsistencies. Where one week somebody is the favorite and the next week somebody else is, and then everyone has a mishap and then somebody stumbles and then they go ahead and rise up from that challenge. It's all scripted and it's all fake, but it's entertaining for her, and that's fine. But Katy Perry, Lord knows she isn't doing anything important with her influence other than trouncing America. This whole message doesn't talk about the root cause, mental health, which is an extremely important thing that Katy Perry could latch onto and talk about. She could talk about the money for the school to have the right security in place, training the teachers on what to do, doing more school shooting drills. Yes, it is a problem. Until we can somehow snap our fingers and wish upon a star, we're going to be facing things like this. And the country has faced this since it's been in existence. Violence happens. It's horrible. But what you don't know, or what you may not know, is that over 600,000 crimes, felonious crimes, felonious crimes, crimes that are going to result in a death or bodily harm or rape. And these are the worst felonies. 600,000 are prevented a year by personal firearm ownership. And over 1.5 million other crimes, whether it be robbery or whether it be death threats or an abusive boyfriend keeping him away from the house or someone trying to get in through a window and a shotgun clacking, whatever it is, 1.5 million of those crimes are deterred. When we look at death, so many gun deaths are related to homicides in the inner cities. This is a topic we should bring up, where mass shootings are considered to be four or more, and these gang-style shootings that happen all the time in Chicago, in Tampa, in Atlanta, in Los Angeles, in Baltimore, are adding up to the school shooting or the mass shooting totals. But we can also look at accidental shootings and firearm safety. There are so many things we can do other than hate America. And I will say this to most celebrities. I don't sit there and tell you how to sing. I don't sit there and tell you how to act or chop a salad. Maybe you shouldn't tell Americans what to do about their liberties, which each one of them is inherent for all of us. And none of you have a right to take it away because you're scared or over-emotional and dramatic on TV. Folks, thanks for watching tonight. If you like what you heard, do me a favor. Go over to At The Dumb Show in the bottom left-hand corner and follow me, or go to my URL and do the same, and you can go pick up some hats and shirts and all that stuff. Even I market and try to make money as well. I don't have a sad story for you, except that we're trying to pay rent and feed my children, and unless you buy a hat, they'll starve. Folks, we're here at 8:30 live tonight. 8 o'clock, actually. We're going to be reviewing the January 6 tapes on the Tucker Carlson Show. I want to see what they have to say. We also do a recorded show every single weeknight. You can stop by and watch and listen to that as well. God bless, and I will see you tomorrow. I will go out with the Veteran Crisis Hotline, which is always important. Mental health to our veterans is a critical thing to be aware of. Please take down this number and information and give it to a vet if you think they need it. God bless and good night.
I'm David Boreanaz with the Cast the SEAL team. And we have an important message for returning vets.
We want you to know if you're struggling to cope, there's help, and it's just a phone call away.
The Veterans Crisis Line is staffed with experienced professionals who know your struggles.
There's no greater sacrifice than service to our country. We're able to enjoy our freedoms because of it.
Your service is important. You are important.
For vets and their families, the Veterans Crisis Line is here to help 24 hours a day. Please call